past weekend, and especially today, we actually have a high risk, which in some parts of the country has not seen for over 10 years.
Wow.
So it is very serious. We do have a major severe weather outbreak expected for today into other parts of the country, not back here at home. So if you are traveling into parts of Texas, Oklahoma, mainly western Texas, Oklahoma, where we're already starting to see some storms spark up and then make their way into Kansas. So this is the area that we are watching. You have this warm front up ahead, this disturbance back behind. Once those two do collide and we have this dry line, that's how we can spark up a lot of these storms. There's just a lot of instability in the atmosphere, and this is why we do have the potential for really that severe weather outbreak for today. So we have not seen, as just mentioned, about 10 years into some areas this high risk. So that is the 5 out of 5 on our severe storm risk scale here, and that's that pink, this purple color, just this bullseye over West Texas, also western Oklahoma. So definitely have to watch for this. And really, just about 6 years ago, that's when we did have that Moore, Oklahoma tornado. It was an EF5 that moved through into parts of Oklahoma. So have to watch for this severe weather outbreak for today. Thankfully not impacting us, but hopefully there isn't too much destruction and devastation to go throughout today, tonight, and tomorrow with this whole system. But if you're traveling this way, definitely stay weather aware. Back here at home, we just have that low end of the risk, the thunderstorms, really not too much expected as we go throughout even all of today. And most of all that activity does just come for the afternoon and then into the evening. So out to the west, that is what we are watching. There's that cold front that will push off towards the east. And as you can see, there's just not a whole lot of moisture rain associated with it just yet. That's really going to stay the trend even as we go throughout the afternoon into the evening. Even for this morning, not much out there, just those clouds passing on by. Here's for your hour-by-hour forecast as we go throughout today for your Monday. Starting this morning about 9 o'clock and through lunchtime, just the clouds still building, hanging around, temperatures to low 80s. So I know we have graduation going on. Shouldn't ruin any of those plans for this morning, even through the lunch hour. Do those scattered showers trying to make their way here by lunchtime just out to the west. By about 3, 4 o'clock, that's when that front starts to really make its way into the area. Staying very light activity, also very scattered. So it's not going to be a washout, not the widespread coverage and rain and storms, even as it does push down to the south and the east. Still staying very light, could see an isolated storm or two, why we do have that low severe storm risk for today, but really not looking too likely. That does continue to push down to the south and the east as we go throughout the evening, as this whole system does dissipate and just push on out. So clearing things out by about 8, 9 o'clock. I know we have baseball games for tonight. Really shouldn't see too much as far as a rain delay. Rainfall totals less than a couple tenths of an inch. Back behind that cold front, we have a northwest wind. Drier and cooler conditions for Tuesday and Wednesday. The heat comes back on Thursday.